Hey guys, it's Dan here. This is a very nerdy tutorial, but a good one for those of you who don't have a lot of money to spend on plugins. If any of you have ever been interested in mid-side processing for mastering, this is the tutorial for you. Okay, so today I'm going to cover mid-side processing. I'm not talking about the processing of a mid and side stereo miking setup, but instead how to convert any stereo track to mid-side and then back again to stereo after you're done messing with it. I'm a major nerd when it comes to audio. I go to bed thinking about, you know, signal flow and interesting ways that I could process audio. And this one was really bugging me for a while. Now, I know that Graham over at therecordingrevolution.com is a big advocate of this kind of approach, using what you already have rather than spending the money that you don't have on plugins and expensive things. And he's got loads of great tutorials you should check out if you haven't already. I'm a huge fan. So this video is what I would have wanted when I was searching for the answer to how to set it up. So it's the mid-side matrix. I found plenty of tutorials on how to decode a figure eight and a cardioid microphone using the mid-side stereo miking technique. And I'm happy to cover this again if you guys want me to. Just send me an email, which will be in the information section below. So when I learned that, it got me to thinking about the mid-side processing that goes on in the mastering realm, which is different to the mid-side microphone setup. Mid-side processing is a way of mastering a track by having independent control of the middle information and the side information of a stereo track beyond the standard left and right components and being able to process them independently of each other. This tends to lend itself to music more easily because of the way most people mix nowadays. I'm going to cover some theory now, so if you'd like to skip ahead, that's fine. The topics covered are the mechanics of panning, phase or polarity reversal, phase cancellation or partial cancellation, phantom images in stereo, sum and difference, left plus right and left minus right mixes. If you think you already know this stuff, like I said before, then skip ahead to the next section where I'll break down how to set up mid-side processing in Pro Tools. If you're a bit rusty on this stuff, then you might benefit from the theory section. Or if you're just curious on how this stuff works, then by all means, watch on. Okay, so generally speaking, most stereo mixes will have the vocals, bass guitar, bass drum, and snare drum panned to the center. We're talking, you know, mainly your pop, your rock, you know, that kind of thing. Leaving things like guitars, keys, backing vocals, drum overheads, horn sections, and percussion parts mostly panned left and or right. Additionally, things like reverb, delays, echoes can exist in a fair chunk of these outer regions of the mix, giving a sense of space or atmosphere to the song. Now, when we listen to a stereo track, we're listening to both the left and the right sides together, but we can also listen to a stereo track in mono by collapsing the stereo field down to the center, also called summing. One way to do this in Pro Tools is by panning the left and the right sides of the track to the center. This is also referred to as left plus right or right plus left or summing. An interesting way of listening to a stereo mix is when you reverse the polarity or phase of one side only, be it the left side or the right side, and then collapse to mono by panning the left and the right side to the center so that they are directly on top of one another. By having only one side out of phase, the information common to both channels is cancelled out and you will not hear it. But what you will hear, though, is the information that isn't common to both sides, and more specifically, the difference between the channels. The resulting audio is the difference between the channels rather than the sum of both channels. This is referred to as left minus right if you have reversed the polarity or phase of the right side, or right minus left if you reversed the polarity or phase of the left side. So what does this all mean? Well, in the truest mono listening environment, we will only have one speaker and a very definite central point from which the music is coming from. With the addition of a second speaker, and in an ideal listening position in front of an equal distance from the two speakers, the center image is perceived as coming from between the speakers. This is the phantom image. When we pan a mono sound source from center to, say, hard left, both of the speakers are producing the sound at an equal level, and then gradually the left side becomes louder as we move the pan knob. whilst the right side becomes softer. At hard left, all of the sound is coming only from the left speaker and none from the right. This basic principle explains the reason why if we pan a guitar 50% to the right, a significant portion of the amplitude of that signal is still playing in the left speaker. In the case of left minus right, or right minus left listening, it is the difference in amplitude between both sides that determines how much of that signal is spared or left over after the cancellation occurs, due to one side being out of phase. For example, if the left speaker is producing 50 decibels and the right is producing 70, you can safely assume that the pan knob is turned toward the right side, but not hard right. Being that there is a difference of 20 decibels between the two sides, when you collapse to mono and invert the phase on one side, say left minus right, the amplitude common to both sides, which is 50 decibels in this case, will cancel out, and your signal will drop down by the level of the quietest side, leaving the difference of 20 decibels, and that's what you'll hear. When listening to a complex stereo mix in left minus right, there will be varying degrees of cancellation going on each instrument, dependent upon where they are panned in the mix. The more centered the instrument, the more likelihood that both speakers are producing that instrument at equal levels. Equal levels means there is no difference, and no difference means 100% cancellation. You will not hear it. Left minus right or right minus left in itself can give an interesting perspective on a producer's particular choice of effects. You'll hear more of the room, reverbs, delays, echoes, more of the subtle components like shaker parts, whispered vocals, etc. All of which that belong to everything that is not 100% centered in the mix. This is the side information of the mid-side process. So here are the formulas. Mid equals a half times left plus right. Side equals a half times left minus right. To decode back to stereo, we use left equals mid plus side. Right equals mid minus side. We can't divide by 2 in Pro Tools or times by a half, but what we can do is lower both the copies of the track by 6 dB and effectively halve the voltage, and this enables us to do our processing. This is really confusing at first, but if you take the time to understand it, it's not so bad. Some people will get this straight away, but if you're like me, you'll probably understand it better by doing it first. So let's move on to our session.